I think we need it this coming year. All right, we've had some scattered showers around, not obviously as much as the last couple of days, but still that broad circulation associated with Nicholas is bringing in the Gulf moisture and some scattered showers and thunderstorms across the region. No coverage has not been as bad, and what we have seen develop is moving. Now, at times you kind of get some back building of showers, but so far nothing that would lead to any flooding threats, and really been relatively dry on both sides of the lake. Metro area dry, some scattered showers, thunderstorms offshore, but most of that deep moisture where you have more of the constant rainfall has shifted well off to our east. Again, that drier air did play a huge role in that. And you also see kind of a little boundary that has developed to our north. Looks like that is moving north and may focus for a little bit more rainfall there during the course of the late evening and overnight. Rainfall totals also not nearly as high as we had seen, and less coverage across the area. Nothing officially reported at Kennard today, and a few scattered showers are still possible through the overnight period, but most coming to an end. This model indicating a little bit more development during the overnight, early morning hours tomorrow, and then scattered showers and thunderstorms as we continue throughout the day on Friday. And again, with that risk of a few isolated downpours and the ground saturated, the flash flood watch remains in effect through tomorrow evening, although rain chances over the weekend, even after the flood watch is expired, look to be about the same as what we're expecting tomorrow. But we saw more sunshine today, and it was certainly a drier day. 86 degrees our current temperature, but with dew points in the mid 70s, still feels like the upper 90s and even at times triple digits. 88 our high, that is exactly the normal for this time of year. But notice our morning lows aren't quite as mild. We're in the 70s on both sides of the lake, mid and upper, and probably going to stay there for the next couple of days. And we're all in the 80s right now. Few spots were able to get into the low 90s, and with high dew points, that heat index does make it feel more like the upper 90s and low triple digits. Bit of a breeze at times with winds out of the south, and the coastal flood advisory remains in effect as well until we can see the wind shift or at least lessen, which won't really happen until this weekend. There's a little spin in the atmosphere. You see this right here? This is an upper level low, and what that's going to do is kind of keep that constant flow of tropical moisture over the northern Gulf Coast for the weekend and into early next week. But there are some changes coming. We are looking at a cold front to move on through. Now, with that moisture in place, I don't really see any reason that rain chances shouldn't be about uniform through about Tuesday. But as I mentioned, we will see a change coming. Daily rain chances into early next week. But look at this on the horizon. A cold front, a real cold front, will move through with a deep upper trough, and less humid but also cooler temperatures will arrive for the middle to end of next week. Dew points will be coming down. This is a look at next week. Again, that low humid or that high humid air with temperature, dew point temperatures into the low 70s. But here comes that dry air during the day Wednesday and Thursday. And along with it, not only drier air, but cooler air. High temperatures toward Wednesday and Thursday will be in the low 80s. Some models actually have our highs in the upper 70s by the end of next week. Not going quite that low, but certainly a sign that this will be more of a real cold front. Few areas that we're watching out in the tropics, none of them look like they're threatening us. The only one that we might have to keep a closer watch on is Invest 95, as it looks like by the early part of next week we'll be approaching the islands, but most of the models indicate it's going to take us a track that will keep it off the east coast and away from the Gulf of Mexico. So at the moment, the tropics remain quiet for us. We need a break. Not much change really going through next Tuesday. Highs upper 80s, near 90, and daily rain chances. Then that cold front moves through, and beautiful weather is on the way by late Wednesday and Thursday.
All right, Chris, thank you. Yom Kippur ends this